Habited. Today is Thursday, May the 10th. Just woke up. I slept in, you guys. I know. Rocky always talking about waking up early and being productive. No, I don't. I'm just kidding with y'all. But it's currently like 1 o'clock. I didn't fall asleep till maybe like 2 or 3 last night. You know, on my phone. That grind never stopped. Just kidding. It's like lurking like through Instagram pages. It's like you click on someone's and then you end up at their cousin's profile and then their cousin's dog profile and then the dog's neighbor's profile. And it's just like a never-ending cycle. But regardless, you guys, I'm going to show you guys what I'm going to have for breakfast. Super late start to the day, but that's okay because that's what days off from work are meant to be, I think. Yeah, don't take it from me, though. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and make some pancakes today because you guys know I am not the pancake whiz, but I am like the little, like, the Joker that gets killed making pancakes. Got some turkey bacon with some egg whites and of course some spinach because health. While I have this ginormous pancake making, I'll go ahead and show you guys my morning supplements. So of course I'll have a full glass of BCAAs, and depends, you guys, if I'm gonna go to the gym like at 11 right after I wake up and then I have caffeine right before, then I won't take a fat burner. But today I probably won't go to the gym till like 5 or 6, so I'm going to take one capsule of Burn XS and one full scoop of Best BCAAs. And as always, shameless plug coming through. Rocky T could save you 20% over at bpysports.net if you want to support your boys. So I could buy I can't really eat anything right now. Lightly salted rice cakes. If you guys use my coupon code, you guys could help me feed myself. Going on YouTube fam, haven't hit you guys up with a commentary in quite some time, so I think this will be the first commentary for Summer Shred series. I'm just gonna go ahead and talk about today's workout. So we started off with the incline bench press, working with 185 pounds. We kept it 5 sets, did the 5 reps, I believe. Surprisingly, you guys, I haven't lost a buttload of strength throughout this prep. Of course, my legs always suffer, or they always take the hardest hit when it comes to cutting and strength, I guess you can say. But, sorry, guys, it's like 1 in the morning. I want to get this video up by tomorrow, which is Monday. I was supposed to have this video up by Friday. Back to the workout. So this was a chest and back workout, you guys. I am still following the Summer Shreds program that I designed. It's like a 12-week program, but for this prep, I'll give myself a 10-week prep. What else can I do for the prep? And build it up. We are officially 4 weeks out to the Summer Shredding Classic that's taking place in Houston, Texas. Alpha dudes are hosting it, so if you guys are in the Houston area and want to go support your boy, I would greatly, greatly appreciate it if you go out to celebrate and have some pizza. So far, it's me and my sister. We're rolling through to the 8th. Gonna get Liddy Titty. Speaking of Liddy Titty, tried out this seated chest cable fly, you guys. The pump was insane. My itty bitty titty committee. It's getting litty titty. But yeah, so super stoked about this competition, you guys. In the next video, I'm going to be talking about what are my plans after the Summer Shredding Classic, because you know your boy likes to get in at least 1 or 2 competitions throughout the year just to, I don't know, stay shredded, not forever, no, because that's painful and whatnot. I don't know what to tell you guys, man. Today is the first day that my body felt fatigued, felt tired, just felt like I got hit by a train, got wrecked. Me and Trevor laughing at something stupid as always, but I'm not gonna tell you guys what it is because it's not suitable for YouTube and I want to give a live for some reason. So regardless, guys, 4 weeks out, Summer Shredding Classic, Houston, Texas, June 15th, I believe. Ready to give you last 4 weeks of prep, my all, and stay tuned on how to cure your cravings during your diet.
So you guys, I figured I'd show you today's cardio regimen. Normally Troy and I will do the Stairmaster or we'll switch off to an incline treadmill walk. Today we are doing the treadmill walk. We're doing 40 minutes of cardio, we're keeping an incline at 0.5, speed 3.6 to 3.8. We're doing 40 minutes today, burn at least like 450 calories or so. Checking with you guys right now.
No, wait, is it recording? I hope. Hold on, let me check. Boop. Yeah. So fam bam, the topic I want to talk to you guys in today's video are cravings while you're dieting. And could you, what is that word called? Satisfy. Satisfy your cravings while you're dieting? Of course. So let me show you guys one prime example that I picked up at HEB really quick. This way. So, one guilty pleasure of mine are sweets when I'm dieting, just like anyone else. So I picked up these Oreo Thins, and the macros are as follow: 6 grams of fat, 21 carbs, 1 gram of protein for 4 cookies. So usually, guys, I'll give myself a refeed meal once every 10 days, or when I feel like losing weight too quick. So I'll go ahead and just give myself a refeed meal, and it'll keep me sane. Also, that's like the purpose of a refeed meal, you guys, just to spike your carb insulin a little bit, so that way your body, if it's like a constant weigh-ins throughout like a week and a half, then a refeed meal will help spark that carb insulin. That'll get your body like, oh shit, we're supposed to lose weight again, and drop it. So that's why you guys see me posting on my Instagram story or Snapchat like a burger and fries like once every week or once every 10 days. So today I decided to pick up some Oreos because I've been craving them, and so there are healthier options out there like those Oreo Thins. So I'm gonna go ahead and enjoy them tonight. God bless.